problem number 13. In this problem number 13, Chandra, Bhaskar and Rahu are the partners sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 3:2:1. So the ratio profit and loss ratio is 3:2:1. Their balance sheet as on 31st March 2015 was under given. Then liability side, their creditors 20,000, bills payable 10,000, capital account Chandra 30,000 and Bhaskar 20,000, Rahu 20,000. So here Bhaskar and Rahu, their capital is equally 20,000 and 20,000. And next assets, cash at bank 10,800. Debtors 12,700, stock 30,000, investment is 10,500, fixed assets 36,000.
Next, cash at bank is 10,800, debtors 12,700, stock 30,000, investment 10,500, and fixed assets 36,000. So these are the liabilities and assets. On the above date, Rahu retired from this business. Rahu is the third partner, then he retired from that business in the following conditions. First, fixed assets are revalued at 42,000. Actually, fixed assets given in balance sheet 36,000 and it is revalued at 42, so 6,000 increased. So that is the appreciation. So this appreciation, fixed assets, then we should write in revaluation account credit side. And again, this 6,000 added to this old figure 36,000, then we get 42,000. And depreciate stock by 1,700. Stock is decreased. 30,000 is old figure is given. Now it is depreciate stock by 1,700. So it comes in revaluation account debit side. Next, provide for bad debt 700. Direct amount given, rate of is not given on the debtors, so directly given 700 also. We should record this debit side in revaluation account. Next, goodwill of the firm is valued 18,000. Total goodwill of that firm is 18,000. The share of goodwill payable to Rahu will be contributed by continuing partners without raising goodwill account. So here in this problem, we need not prepare goodwill account. Why? Because without raising goodwill, we will contribute that. So next, ratio of gaining Chandra and Bhaskar is 1:1 respectively. So gaining ratio 1:1, then old ratio is 3:2:1. So here directly gaining ratio is given. So when the gaining ratio is given, that goodwill is distributed in this gaining ratio. Then next one, so this is the problem. So first we should write this problem. Will start with capital accounts. So by capital accounts, so your partner Chandra, next Bhaskar, next Rahu, again Chandra, Bhaskar, Rahu. So it start with capital account credit side by balance brought down. By balance brought down, that is 30,000, 20,000 and 20,000. So these are the capitals of their partners. Then bills payable, I think no adjustment is given. Then as it is, it we should write this liability side, bills payable. That is, bills payable is 10,000. Next, same time, creditors. Creditors, that is 20,000. So liability side completed. Then next one is asset, cash at bank. So that is also asset. Cash at bank 10,800. Next, debtors 12,700. Next, here bad debts, provide for bad debts minus provision for bad debts 700, directly given in our problem. So 12,700 minus 700, 12,000. So it is the loss for the business. Then we should write debit side in revaluation account to provision for bad debts. Provision for bad debts, that is 700. Next, stock 30,000. Stock 30,000. Here depreciation is stock by 700 or 1700 minus depreciation 1700. So it is 28,300. So your stock decreased. When the asset is decreased, we should write debit side to stock account. That is 1700. Next one is investment. So no adjustment is given, then we should write as it is asset side investments. So that is investments is 10,500. Next one is fixed assets. Here fixed assets 36,000. Now it is increased to 42,000. Now new figure is 42,000, old figure is then 36,000. Difference between these two amount is, so that is appreciation. Appreciation is 6,000. So 36,000 plus 6, 42,000. So it is increased here by fixed assets. So that is 6,000.